power, individualism, grandeur. You may wonder why I speak these words, but what if I told you that it was because they embody a woman who had a profound impact on the world of theater? Why, that woman is me, Sarah Bernhardt. Now allow me to tell you the story of my very intriguing life and the unique adventure I went on as an actress in the early world of this theater. Please allow me to set the scene. I was born in the Latin Quarter of Paris in the year 1844 to a Dutch Jewish escort and the son of a wealthy merchant. My mother, leading this very eccentric lifestyle, placed me under the protection of a nursery at a very young age. Although in my youth I was a Roman Catholic and I was baptized as such, I remained proud of my Jewish heritage, and I even proclaimed that I was a member of the great Jewish race. I would say that I was naturally attracted to the theater because in my youth I was very emotionally moved by the performances that I saw there quite frequently. Also, I was just very a friendly person and I enjoyed communicating with people quite often, so the theater supplied me with just that. I was also just a creature of change and diversity, and I wanted to explore and experience all walks of life. I also felt that through the frequent changes in my characters that I played on the stage, I could achieve just this. At the age of 7, I was sent to a boarding school for young girls, and this is where I performed my first role of my life. It was in the play Clotilde. And here, I performed one of my many iconic death scenes in my life. Believe it or not, I'd never really considered acting. Till I had a very emotional experience whenever I went to go see a play at a company called La Comédie Française. As a person who has natural intrigue for all things in life, I realized that this is what I wanted to do. After that, I quickly auditioned for a school called La Paris Conservatoire with the help of my friend who was the then Duke of Morny. And with his help, I won the judges over with a fable called The Two Pigeons by La Fontaine. And after that, I became a student there. After my training at the Paris Conservatoire, I went on to an audition for La Comédie Française. And I actually starred in the title role there for the play Iphigénie. However, I didn't stay there for very long because as it happened, the critics did not like me very much. I'm sure if you would sure to ask my family and friends, they would say that I am a very naturally inspiring, positive person. I would also say that I do have a bit of a temper and it does tend to get me in a bit of trouble. I remember once that I actually slapped a senior actress because she was quite rude to my sister. I don't really regret that though, I will be honest. I was also quite noted for my unique voice. Because of that, they called it a golden bell. I was also referred to as the queen of the pose and the princess of gesture. Naturally, I tend to act with great flamboyance and grandeur, which admittedly did not always translate well in the world of film, but I definitely still made my mark in that industry as well. But under the gaze of the playwright Sardou, I worked quite well with him, and I starred in many of his plays. But if you were to ask any person alive today who Sarah Bernhardt was, they would probably say that she was known for her dramatic death scenes and also for playing roles as a boy. Accompanying this fact was of course the title role in the play Hamlet by Shakespeare, in which I played both a male and also had quite the dramatic death scene. After I left La Comédie Française, I did a bit of soul searching. And fortunately, eventually, I landed with a company called L'Odéon Théâtre. And that is really where I would say that my reputation as an actress started to develop and evolve. My most successful performance there was the role of Zenetto in a one-act play called La Passion. However, in terms of the climax of my reputation, it would definitely be for me whenever I developed my own traveling theatre company, and that is really whenever I started to gain a lot of international success. Of the performances in Malcompagnie, my most sought after performance in those days was Margarita Gautier in the play Les Dames aux Camélias. Maintenant, vous comprenez le corps de ma vie. J'espère certainement que cette conversation sera utile pour le futur. Au revoir.